UVI Shade blends EQ, filtering and modulation and merges them into one plugin. I'm Marlon and welcome to the White Noise Studio. When you first open UVI Shade, you will see that the plugin looks like a pretty normal EQ. Double click or click on the plus sign here to add an EQ band, and with right click you can select all sorts of EQ bands and types. Now, as you can see, here is where it already gets interesting, since the plugin offers phaser, comp, flanger and special menu options. The plugin can be used as a normal EQ plugin. The controls work intuitively. Drag the band and use command or control to change the Q or bandwidth. Each band can be switched from stereo left-right, stereo mid-side, just left, right, mono or side processing. Versatile controls. The plugin also has a nice dry wet control, which will be useful when you use the plugin for which it stands out. And that is its really creative EQing and filtering, and is a must when you use the phaser and flanger effects because of how those effects work. Now, speaking of the creative filtering, you set that up by first adding a frequency band. Let's start simple with a peaking band. I open the lower bar by pressing this little knob here. This opens the modulators bar. With this big plus sign, you can add modulators. Here are all modulator modules. The controls of the frequency bands can be controlled by these modulators. Let me show you. Let's select the LFO. By itself, it does nothing. You have to assign what it does. You grab it and drag it to a knob. This assigns the LFO to the frequency dial. I want the LFO to also control the slope. And now I will do the other way of assigning the modulators, and that is by right-clicking on a knob and select L1, the LFO. As you can see, I can also select the other modulators here, but let's stick with this one first. You can see the LFO is moving the frequency now. I want it to move the slope more. And for that I go to the L1 by the slope knob, and you see the arrow change. Now I can adjust how much the modulator modulates this knob. Just as is with, for instance, Native Instruments Massive or Waves OVAX. Now you can see that the slope changes a lot more. Let's use the phaser tilt resonant on the synth pad. I will now add the modulator called figure, and its X and Y axis will control the Q width and spacing of the phaser. Now, the plugin is not restricted to one modulator per band. By pressing the plus, you can add more modulators. Let's add a normal LFO to add even more movement to the phaser. It will sound like this. Let's start with a clean plate again on this synth pad and use the MSAC modulator. The MSAC module is what UVI calls a multi-step envelope generator. I call it a step sequencer, so you know immediately how to work with it. This one is one of the coolest features of the plugin, since this one allows you to do all sorts of intricate automation steps. They have made this one and most of the other modulators syncable to the tempo of the project. And I think that was a wise move. You can create up to 32 steps, and it can work stepped or linear. Let me select a preset. Let's add a comp filter resonant. By dragging, you see the filter happening. Okay, let's assign the MSAC to the comp filter. Let me add the figure modulator and assign it. You can assign almost every knob to every knob and band. You can see how complicated it can get and how much you can modulate. And there are more modulators you can use. And a whole lot of EQ bands. I'm not going to show you all 36 EQ types and all 9 modulators and its infinite combinations. This is a plugin you really need to get hands-on with. Download the trial and start experimenting with it. It will be worth it. The link is in the description below. You noticed it's easy to create weird effects with just a few tweaks and dialing a few knobs. Imagine how wild you can get, and I didn't even use the sidechain function or MIDI control of this plugin. But you also can use this plugin as a great tool in mixing. Let me show you how. How about using the plugin as a noise gate to reduce, for instance, a reverby audio track from a video? Let's use this video.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
First, let's add a band by double clicking on the area, boost and sweep around a bit.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this
around here, there's quite some reverb happening. So that is what we want to work on. The module for this will be the envelope follower, since that follows the volume of the voice. The idea is that you reduce the gain of the frequency band where the reverb is and let the envelope follower boost the voice only when it's happening above the threshold. And with that, it creates a gate.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. 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 Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
Let's apply a global gate by using the gain function and let it modulate by the envelope follower.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. 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 Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
Now you get even more of a gate, especially when you adjust the settings, like for instance the release. From here you can EQ the voice.
Please remember to subscribe to this channel. Please remember to subscribe to this channel.
Now this sounds a little bit unnatural, but tweak the settings until you like it. So you can also use this on snare and drums for gating and sculpting. Let's focus on fine-tuning this drum loop. Here's the plugin with two multi-step envelope generator modules on a simple EQ on the drum loop. I have one MSEC band triggering a boost on the snare frequencies on the backbeat, and I have one MSEC on the bass drum. This is with, and this is without. On the snare, it's pretty obvious how it works. In this way, you can bring out the snare in a loop without affecting the rest of the loop. You hear, of course, some cymbal bleed on the first snare and a bit on the second, but you get the idea. On the kick, this may seem a bit unnecessary. A normal boost would also do the trick like this. By triggering the boost though, I only focus on the kick and the two toms at the end remain untouched. You can do this with EQ automation, of course, but this way it's flexible and you can really easily fine-tune the boost. I didn't really go in depth in this video and I barely scratched the surface of the possibilities. If you want to know more about other modulation plugins, check out the video displayed on screen right now. Please remember to subscribe to this channel and like this video. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!